I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Today is Tuesday, June 19th, 2018, 6 p.m. This is a regular meeting of the Greensburg Water Board called to order. To comply with Title VI of the Civil Rights Act of 1964, the city requests that participants in this meeting complete a voluntary anonymous survey that is available on the table in the back of the room. Have a roll call on it.
Chuck?
Here.
Tony?
Here.
Frank is absent. Brian?
Here.
Robin?
Here.
The minutes from May 15th, 2018's meeting were distributed in your packet. Is there any objections or corrections to the minutes as distributed? No, they'll be accepted. New business, HMTB update. Aaron?
Apologize for the poor quality of my video there, but we are we're thick into design right now. I think we're pretty close to having the overall layout, that being there'll be some tweaks, but the major components I think are pretty much set in place, and I kind of walk that through here hopefully with this. This line here represents the new or the existing raw water line. It's the incoming water. It'll come in there, we'll have a new line somewhere in this street, we'll intercept that. Then it'll come over to these two circular clarifiers. And then from there, comes up through here, and into, and it's hard to see, this is the new, what we call water treatment plant number 4. The chemical feeds are on this end, offices kind of areas in the middle. And then these are the treatment facilities, filters over on this end here. Water will then come into the filters and out of the filters into the clear well here, to this big tank down here. And then when you need water to the distribution, there's a pump facility or pump room here, and that will pump the water out and then back into the distribution system. We're still trying to determine if it's best to tie in along existing Ireland, or we may tie in on the east side of plant number 3, someplace in this area. So some of those kind of details are still being worked out. A couple things, in the last month we met with Ron and Kathy, kind of discussed the vacating of portions of the streets and the alleys. Basically, the intent was to basically create a compound for the water plant so that this whole basic area would be able to be fenced in and secured from that standpoint. What that means is this portion of Ireland would be vacated, and this portion of 5th Street would be vacated. And then because it's currently a through street, what we're doing is going to make a cul-de-sac here. This will probably be in an easement, and we'll fence that around so that we'll have to take the fence around that cul-de-sac. So we'll still be able to, basically cul-de-sac is to the residents along 5th Street so they you can still be able to get bus turnaround, garbage trucks. And as far as fire, we'll have a gate so that if the fire has to get through with their big truck, they'll have the ability to open a gate and be able to utilize this through this. We're not getting rid of the pavement per se, it will just become part of the interior drive system, driveways or drives of the plant itself. And with that, then there's a couple alleys right through here, and then along the back side that we're looking to vacate and utilize some of that space as well, since now it's not the streets anymore, we can vacate delineate those alleys and utilize that space, the area there. So keep in mind, I guess those houses are here. The property line, there's an existing alley right down here. That will stay. And then half of this alley that runs along here, from these first three houses here, will stay. And then we'll take the entire run here. That's the plan at this point in time. So one other thing, in the last month, we did meet with Duke Energy. There's some existing overhead lines. There's one that lines right here where we got the new tank. Its purpose was to serve a couple residents that, you know, you purchased the one property here. So that no longer is really needed. So Duke can just move back a pole and eliminate that section of line. So they're looking through that, looking through their options of how they will address that. The bigger one is there's an existing line that runs in this alleyway right here, from here to there, that it gets really close to some of our existing structures, especially this one up here. So we asked them to look if they had other options to reroute that. They're exploring that and the costs associated with that. Basically, you know, they also, on top of their poles, they have, you know, you have your other communications, your telephone, cable, and those sort of things. But until Duke makes a decision how they want to reroute their lines, there's really no need to talk to the other communication companies, because they're going to just, whatever Duke does, they're going to follow Duke. So right now, Duke is looking into that, and we hope to hear something back from them in probably a month or so. They're going to look into adjusting, you know, with the revenue that the additional facilities will generate revenue and offset that, and they'll come back with a cost. And at that point in time, you know, we'll start evaluating if that's cost effective, or if we have to make some changes to ours to mitigate some of that. If it comes back unreasonable, then we'll have to do some changes after that. So we're trying to get them, as soon as we had a pretty good layout, we got them involved to see what that's going to be. That's kind of been some of the things we've done in the last month. Any questions?
When was the fencing going to go up or vacate the streets?
The fencing will probably be one of the last things to go up once they, everything's constructed. The idea was that once you construct everything, right now there's no way of really isolating or securing many of the facilities at the site, because you do have this public right of way through here. So the idea was that once we could take that out, make this more of a complex, a compound or campus, so that we can secure that with fencing around. Right now, the only real fencing you have on the site is this plant number 3 that was built in 2008 and 2009. That facility is secured with fencing. We'd be looking at putting some type of similar fencing up there. You know, the other thing that, you know, we'll have a gate here, normally that'd be the normal entrance. We'll also have a secondary, maybe 2 gates back here. We've got a gen set and some pumping things that we may need to, on occasions, to have to get big trucks in there to work on that, so we need to give them access. So there's probably going to be a couple gates that, you know, with the perimeter that we'll have to do. But the idea is to try to secure the perimeter. One of the reasons they had built this north building years ago was to try to secure this tank, this open tank. So but hopefully we'll be able, you know, we've got, these are going to be open tanks too, and so we'll be able to secure that with that. And I saw that Rick's got security cameras on the agenda, so that may lead into some of his discussion as well. Other questions?
Again.
So hopefully we're fast approaching the August 1st is when we plan to have the 50% submittal to you guys, and then we'll have a workshop after that to kind of really dig down into the details with Rick's staff and stuff. And we'll probably have I'll bring some of my colleagues that are much more tech savvy than I am, and we'll put together more of a presentation, and hopefully walk you through a little for the citizens.
Thanks, Darren. Chemical beds, Mr. Rick.
Good evening. I have a question for Mr. Tibby, actually. One of the bids was emailed to me today. So I got the letter that we officially sent out. It does not say anything in there about being sealed bids. So I have two was delivered to the clerk's office. I have one that was emailed to me today. Can we still utilize that bid? From what I read, yes, because there's nothing in there that states that that's the first time it's ever happened. That's Brentag, one that we've dealt with for years and years and years. And so why it happened this way, I can't answer, but.
On time?
Yeah, I received it today, so.
Yeah, I think it could be considered as long as we had a specified delivery method, so.
Okay.
You've received it, obviously, so.
Yes. With that being said, I'll go ahead and read off the Brentag. Do you want me to read off all the prices? Do you want me to put it together and bring it back next month, or how? Want me to read off all the prices?
I think in the past you've done that, but you haven't forced it brought back,
yeah.
Right, Chuck?
Yeah. Okay. Compare apples to apples, because a lot of times it's a 50-pound cylinder to 75 or.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay, so you want me just to tell who they are? And
that'd be fine.
All right, the first one I got was emailed to me from Brentag. It appears that they're bidding on everything that we requested. PVS Chemicals are out of Ohio. That's who we are currently using right now. They're bidding on everything except chlorine. That's what they did last year also. And our third and final bid was from JCI. Typically they just bid on chlorine. They're just bidding on chlorine again this year. That is correct.
Very good.
That was from Jones Chemical, just chlorine. I will put these together on a spreadsheet for next month, and then like Chuck said, we can compare apples to apples then and make a decision then. Ago about getting a security camera system at the plant. I got this quote from Mad Technical Services. This is for 16 cameras. The price you see of $11,388 is for all 16 cameras. After meeting with Doug Burton, he suggested that we use at this time to use 10. For the price of $7,345, that's everything for the camera system, the install, everything. This is a system that I believe he said the groundwater plant, they'll have to hardwire the cameras over to that area. Around the plant one, plant two, for whatever reason, I guess they can do that without hardwiring, I guess from radio or I don't know how that works. So So I'm requesting up to the $11,388. This is a system we can move to the new plant once we get the plant up and running. And then I'm requesting that amount just so in the future, once we get the new plant up and running, if we need the 6 additional cameras, we can go ahead and, or I can go ahead and get them.
You're only getting 10 for the 7345?
Yes.
That's what we're doing.
That's what he suggested, okay. Yes.
The 11 is 16 cameras.
Yeah, or we can just do the 7345, and then if or when that time comes, well, I mean, I can, which might be the best way to do it, because 3 or 4 years of cameras might go up a little bit. So I did ask him about a warranty. Everything, it's the system itself has a 2-year warranty on it, the cameras, the whatever goes along with that, and then a year on the install, the wiring, and on their part.
They do good work. I've seen their cameras, pretty good, pretty clear. You looking doing this in all the?
Yeah, I think it's time that we need to start protecting ourselves a little bit stronger, especially my water and my sewer.
I'll move we move forward with purchasing 10 cameras at $7,345 from MadTech.
Motion's been made. We've got a second.
Second.
Motion's been made. Second. Roll call.
Chuck?
Yes.
Tony?
Yes.
Brian?
Yes.
Robin?
Yes.
Upland Dam Inspection.
This is state mandated that we do. If you remember in the past, the state or DNR used to do it for us, and they quit doing that about 6 or 8 years ago. So it's our time to have the dam inspected and submitted reports submitted to the state. You have to do it every 2 years. Christopher Burke, which has done it in the past, last 4 or 5 times, I'm guessing. That's how many times we've been responsible for it. They quoted $4,500 fixed fee to do this, and that's doing the inspection, submitting the report to the state, and everything goes along with that. So I'm requesting permission to go ahead and get that started.
Any reason to think anything's changed up there?
No.
Does it mean geographically, do you notice any changes?
I don't at all. I mean, we keep it mowed, we keep it looking good again this year, and so if there was some, you know, a leak or something, we would surely detect it. I believe we're on it every 2-year rotation because it's considered a high hazard dam where it's at. So in between 74 and you have what we used to have, the houses, which was just below, and the house trailers were there, 3 or 4 trailers, I think. But we're still considered a high hazard dam, and I believe that's why we do it every 2 years.
Did you approve?
What did you say the amount was?
$4,500.
$4,500. I will make a motion. We have Christopher Burke do the inspection on the dam for $4,500. We've got a second.
Second.
Motion's been made and seconded. Roll call.
Chuck?
Yes.
Tony?
Yes.
Brian?
Yes.
Robin?
Yes. Do we need a new truck or anything?
No, that's been enough. That's all I have.
Anything else for us?
I do not.
Everything running smooth?
Yes. Short of Lincoln Street, but.
Yeah.
Actually, I say that, no. I'm not gonna lie to you. Last week was kind of bad. We had 2 broken mains, if you didn't see them out on South Michigan Wednesday night and Thursday night. They worked both those nights till 9 o'clock. So I don't think we did anything on Lincoln Street last week, and even yesterday we had another leak on Fleetwood that they was fixing. So they did get back out there today some, so hopefully we'll start making some more progress out there.
Is that coming along?
pretty good. Yeah, it started out kind of slow. We started on the north end and was working our way south, and they ran into all kinds of trouble on Walnut Street. But that could be expected. There's stuff in the ground that we didn't know was there.
Is it worse than you expected, or
yeah,
worse than you expected? Worse.
Yep.
There's no such thing in the early environment.
But they're down to they're almost down to Central, right at Central, close to Central, and then they only have one block to go to North Street. So I look for the main itself to be put in and with it done by at least by the end of next week. We're doing it.
Okay.
We're doing the water line. What's going to take a little bit longer is getting the service lines, which when I met with Ron the other day, he asked me how long. I said, a week and a half. Well, I didn't think about the service lines. That's pretty important.
Yeah.
We can't kill the old cast iron main until we have all the new services ran and everything. So that's where we're at.
It made some improvement.
Yes.
Yeah.
How was that old main?
I'm not really sure, but it's been in the ground a lot of years.
Yeah.
It's an old cast iron. And, you know, in that section of Lincoln, we haven't really had much trouble that I've known in the last 22 years. Honestly, I don't remember ever doing anything to it, but... we replaced all that and that eliminated that, but all we need is to put a new road and sidewalks and curbs, and then here comes the water company.
Yeah, I'm digging it up.
Digging it up.
Great. Again, any other things? Questions for Rick?
Thank you.
Thanks, Rick. Mayor, anything? Bring forth the board?
No, I know. Thanks. It's a nice, pretty day.
Anybody you'd like to be heard from? Ron?
Nope, I'm good.
Nothing? In that case, adjourn.